With the development of big data networks, various types of switches have been put into use. When purchasing, should we choose a layer 2 switch or a layer 3 switch? What is the difference between them? Next, we will take you to understand. First, we need to understand the concept of layer, which refers to the different layers in the OSI model. The model divides network communication into 7 layers, and data is transmitted from the high layer to the low layer. The 3 layers related to switches are mainly the physical layer, data link layer, and network layer. The network layer handles IP addresses and routing protocols, and the data link layer handles MAC addresses and Ethernet protocols. The IP address is equivalent to the delivery address, and the MAC address is equivalent to your ID card. We need 2 addresses to communicate in order to reach the designated device, and the actual transmission can be the network cable, which belongs to the physical layer. Layer 2 switches, as their name suggests, work at the data link layer and the physical layer. The layer 3 switch works in these 3 layers, with one more network layer than the layer 2 switch. The main difference between them lies in this. The layer 3 switch can realize communication and IP routing between VLANs, but the layer 2 switch cannot. For example, in network communication, a switch will connect multiple computers. At this time, computer A wants to communicate with computer B. Computer A will send the MAC address of computer B to the switch. The switch will then read the target MAC address, check its table, determine which port matches the specified MAC address, and then accurately forward the data to the port of computer B. At this time, they can communicate with each other. This type of switch only recognizes MAC addresses. This is a layer 2 switch. If more computers need to be connected later and more data needs to be communicated, in order not to affect the network and waste computing power, different devices need to be divided into different virtual LANs through VLAN. Each VLAN is an independent area. The data sent in the area cannot be seen by other areas, that is, the original large broadcast range is reduced to multiple intervals. However, if a VLAN-1 device wants to send data to a VLAN-2 device, this involves cross-network communication, usually their IP addresses are different. So, the layer 2 switch can't deal with it, it needs to involve the layer 3 routing function. If we use it daily and only have a layer 2 switch, we need to install another router for communication. If it is a data center or a place with a large number of different VLAN segments, the router processes data slowly. At this time, we need a layer 3 switch, which contains the functions of the 3 layers, and can deal with MAC and IP addresses, and can choose the best path to transmit. But, a layer 3 switch cannot completely replace a router because layer 3 switches do not have WAN ports, which are generally used to access the internet. For general home use, a 2-layer switch can be selected. There are many plug-and-play models, which are convenient and fast. A 3-layer switch is recommended for use in large enterprises or data centers. It requires professional knowledge to configure and has a high threshold for use. The above is our content in this issue. If you are interested, welcome to like or subscribe to us. If you need to know more, welcome to visit qsfptech.com to communicate with us.